In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Ruth died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May Ruth now share with Christ eternal glory. Let us pray. O God, who alone are able to give life after death, free your servant Ruth from all sins, that Ruth, who believes in the resurrection of your Christ, may, when the day of resurrection comes, be united with you in glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Kindly be seated. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain the Lord of hosts will provide for all people. On this mountain he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. On that day it will be said, "Behold our God, to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord for whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us." The word of the Lord.
My rock in all my
A reading from the first letter of John. See what love the Father has bestowed on us that we may be called the children of God. Yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. The word of the Lord. From the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to Jesus, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. Kindly be seated. Dear friends, we gather here in this sanctuary on holy ground where heaven and earth are connected. Whether you come from near or far, you are welcome here. If you come from another religious tradition or affiliation, you are all welcome here. As guests of Ruth's immediate family, your role today and for the days ahead is to bring consolation and comfort to Ruth's family by your presence at their side and by your retelling of favorite stories, so that you might lift up Ruth's family as if on eagle's wings. As Christian believers, we frequently look to the New Testament book of Revelation. There we find this consoling reassurance and promise. Blessed are those who have died in the Lord. Let them rest from their labors, for their good deeds go with them. Although Fred will speak today after Holy Communion about Ruth's good deeds, each of us here today carries within our hearts our own particular list of Ruth's good deeds. We have read what you have written in description of Ruth. Everyone knew her bright smile and friendly welcome at the Franklin Town Hall. Today we also declare with confidence that there are doubtless many good deeds of Ruth's that only God recalls today. Friends, we have already addressed our God in prayer today as the one who is alone able to give life after death. As heirs to the Christian biblical tradition, we believe that God, the Almighty Father, has already decisively displayed this power to give life after death by raising Jesus, his only begotten Son, from the dead on the third day, Easter Day. The sacrament of baptism plunges us all into the death of Jesus and brings us up out of the waters as sharers in the new risen life of Jesus. Dear friends, we spend our days on earth, our allotted time, doing our best to live in this newness of risen life with Jesus and the great company of his followers and friends. In today's prayers over the offerings of bread and wine, we will make this prayer request of God the Father, that Ruth, who did not doubt your son Jesus to be a loving Savior, may find in him a merciful judge. Dear friends, may these words, the songs, and the prayers of the funeral ritual bring you some measure of strength and consolation today and for the days ahead. Kindly stand for the prayers of the faithful. God, the Almighty Father, raised Jesus Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save his people, living and dead. To each petition, please reply, Lord, hear our prayer. For Ruth, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that Ruth may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord. For Ruth, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord. For all of our deceased relatives, neighbors, and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord. For the family and friends of Ruth, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord Jesus, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord. For all of us assembled here to worship together in faith, that we may be gathered together again in the joy and peace of God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Kindly stand. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Ruth, we beseech your mercy, that Ruth, who did not doubt your son Jesus to be a loving Savior, may find in him a merciful judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For Jesus is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through Jesus, the host of angels adores your majesty, and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Seated. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Thank you. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Sean, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Ruth, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that Ruth, who was united with your son Jesus in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Ruth, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of happiness, light, and peace through Christ our Lord. Kindly be seated for Fred's words of remembrance.
Good morning, my family, my son Scott, my daughter-in-law Stacy, my daughter Christine, my son-in-law Scott Ryan, my grandchildren Trevor and Megan Anderson, and Alex Ryan, all thank you for coming to Ruthie's funeral mass. I would just like to read a poem for Ruth that was written by Linda Ellis. I read of a man who stood to speak at the funeral of a friend. He referred to the dates on her tombstone from the beginning to the end. He noted that first came the date of her birth and spoke of the following date with tears. But he said what mattered most of all was the dash between the years. For the dash represents all the time that she spent alive on earth. And now only those who loved her know what that little line is worth. For it matters not how much we own, the cars, the house, the cash, What matters is how we live and love and how we spend our dash. So think about this long and hard. Are there things you'd like to change? For you never know how much time is left that can still be rearranged. If we could just slow down enough to consider what's true and real, and always try to understand the way other people feel, and be less quick to anger and show appreciation more, and love the people in our lives like we've never loved before. If we treat each other with respect and more often wear a smile, remembering that this special dash but only lasts a little while. So when your eulogy is being read with your love's action to rehash, would you be proud of the things they say and about how you spend your dash? Thank you.
Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Ruth, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Ruth again and enjoy her love and friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow today, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend Ruth and the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, Ruth will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Ruth in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with Ruth forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Dear friends, in hope, trust, and peace, let us take Ruth to her place of rest.